Hello, my name is Eugene Mondie. I'm a clarinetist with the National Symphony Orchestra. Today I'd like to talk to you about picking equipment. I think it's important to remember the basics. That is to say, why we do what we do and what we're trying to accomplish. We're trying to serve the music, and I think that's important to remember when we pick our equipment, because it allows us to be objective. And I think that's very important to get out of the parameters of good and bad and look at what works and what doesn't work. One of the reasons that I'm a big supporter of Van Dorn is because I think we get fixated on a mouthpiece and thinking in terms of, that's it, that's the one. When I play my M13 lyre, I know in 2 years this is not going to be the same mouthpiece. And I also know that I'm not going to be the same musician in 2 years. I think it's important that we explore the different sides of the instrument, different aspects of the instrument, and also acknowledge that things change, things wear out, and the availability of this really great mouthpiece is why I play Van Dorn. The reeds, I think, are clearly the best. I mean, I think they have such great quality and depth to them that allow me to do what I need to do, especially the way modern orchestras are playing. As loud as we play, we really need a lot of strength in the reed and depth. Without it, I don't know how else we could do it. I think it's also important that we not become attached to any particular characteristic of the instrument, whether it's the sound or the articulation or whatever it may be, the numbers of the facing or whatever, and evaluate the mouthpiece on its own. And same thing with the reeds. There's a variety of different reeds. Instead of thinking just only this type of reed will work, try a variety of different reeds, because I think it's very difficult to know for sure what's going to work. I think there's multiple possibilities with these relationships on the instrument. It's important to remember that this is a system between the reed, mouthpiece, and clarinet, and that we're basically affected by acoustics, climate, the seasons, and temporal change. That is to say, things wear out. Another important factor is that basically clarinetists are divided into two camps. You either believe the instrument is a high-flow instrument, or you believe it's a low-flow instrument. Knowing this allows you to have a little objectivity as well when you're trying your equipment or someone else's equipment, and realizing where they may be in either of those two camps. I would suggest when you're trying mouthpieces to avoid playing on them too long, because as you play on them, you will adapt your own physiology, and the reed will begin to shape to that particular mouthpiece as well. So my advice is to try something very quickly, and also look for the basic characteristics rather than something ideal. Something as simple as that will tell you the sound, the response, and the depth that you're going to get. I think it's very important that we also try a variety of different mouthpieces. And this is one of the reasons I like Van Dorn very much, because they have a high quality mouthpiece that I can experiment with in my own playing. Because not only do I change, but the weather changes, the seasons change, and this allows me to experiment and try and find out what works best for me. I play a V12 5 Plus with my M13 lyre, and the reason I do that isn't because I sit there and totally rework the reed, but rather it has the characteristics that I'm looking for with the close facing. I want the depth, and I want the volume of sound that I get with a 5+. But it's important to remember, whatever mouthpiece you play on or whatever reed you use, reed strength, I think it's important that you remember that you're getting certain things. For me, I have to put the cushion in through the instrument. If you have an open facing, you would obviously be using a much softer reed, in which case you're struggling to get the point. But it's understanding those relationships that's what's critical, rather than being fixated on any particular strength or model.